Hello everyone, welcome back to Caffeinated Gamer. This video is only about showing you what plants are available. So okay, there is no gameplay that I made other videos on. So I'm only showing you the plants because many people do not have the app yet. So let's just start with this. This is the first one. This is my favorite, Snapdragon. It can kill multiple people at the same time in 3 rows. I personally love this one, and if you feed it a taco, it can also attack air units, so it's almost the best one. Walnut, we all know about it. Star is also a great one. Star fruit, third one. This is also nice. Bamboo shoots, it does a lot of damage, 319, but it takes a lot of time to load, 5.5 seconds, so that is a drawback. This one takes 1 sun, blocks zombies, but I don't use it much. This one is nice. If you want to hit air zombies, then this one does 3 times normal damage. This is good for air zombies. This is the simplest plant, I don't use it much. Pea shooter. Cabbage is again for air zombies. Cabbage pulled. Okay, damage is good, but it takes 3 seconds to load. So that part is bad. Kernel pulled, we have already seen it in Plant vs Zombie 1 and 2. Many plants are same. So okay, it does low damage. The butter part is good, so it can freeze zombies with butter. Okay, I personally use just this one, flaxseed, because its damage is highest. So I just use this one against air zombies. And bong choy. It can hit backwards, that is what makes it different. Otherwise its damage is low. And this one I haven't used much. I used but I wasn't satisfied, so I stopped using it. And pine needle, it attacks multiple zombies at the same time, but I prefer this Snapdragon because it can attack in 3 rows. So this is even better. Other are not unlocked yet, but we can still see them. Garlic, it's the same as in Plants vs Zombie 1 and 2. Pushes zombie, attacking garlic to adjacent lanes. Pungent. And here's the fire pea shooter. Fires flaming peas down her lane, which damages other zombies in the same tile as a target roasted. So this is good. Nice, so this will be unlocked later when we advance in the game, but we can still see them. Hydrangea, weird name, bite zombies at close range. When hydrangea takes damage, she grows another head, increasing her attack speed. So I guess this is good. Damage per second 51 is pretty high. Attack speed is also fine, 1.3 second, but we will unlock it at higher levels. Okay, what else we have here? We have spikeweed. Okay, we have it. We had it in Plant vs Zombie 2 also. Okay, this just looks cooler. This is more animated. Okay, and squash is perfect to squash enemies in 1 second. So whenever enemy gets too close to you, just use a squash. Only takes 2 sun. So it's nice for defense. It's actually great for defense. This is new, dogwood. Barks at zombies, making them take extra damage from all attacks, grows bigger over time, so this is good. We will have to unlock it to actually use it. As I play the game, these will be unlocked and I will make videos on them too. And lightning reed, its damage is low, but the specialty is that it can attack in adjacent rows also. So yeah, otherwise its damage is low, but it can attack in adjacent rows, so that is the advantage. Shuffle trouble, what do you do? Bounces a zombie back into an adjacent lane, then has to recharge. Okay, it takes 1 sun, so that is good. And what does he do? Lemonade. Oh, lemonade, man. Okay, it speeds up all 8 surrounding plants by 28%, but it takes 8 sun, so that is a lot of sun. So I don't know, depends on if you want to use it. Sweet potato, blocks zombies, pulls nearby zombies from adjacent lanes, irresistible. Okay, potato mine is, well, simple, but one thing is different here. In this game, Plant vs. Zombie 3, it cannot be attacked while arming. In Plant vs. Zombie 2 and 1, it could be attacked and eaten while it is aiming. But in 3, it cannot be attacked. It takes time to arm and cannot be attacked while arming, so that is even better. And it only takes one sim, so that is great. And this one looks so sad. She is sick. Ragweed sneezes on nearby zombies to damage them with a chance to push them back. Attack damage is low, attack speed is also bad. It is just, well, okay. Not very great. This is worth. Dead of kernel pult. Caramel popcorn. Okay. Lops popcorn and caramel blobs that stick to the ground. Slowing zombies. Sweet. Okay. Almost nice. It can slow things down, so that is the advantage. Okay. Where were we? Unlock at level 17. That is too far to go. It smashes the first zombie that gets close to it, plus other zombies in the same tile. Also butters surrounding zombies slippery. Butternut squash. Okay, that is nice. Attack damage 900. That is the highest I have seen. 900. For 3 sims, so that is great. Gravity. Oh man, so weird name. Launches orbiting apples that damage nearby zombies. Newtonian. Okay, apple durability 5 hits. So okay, one apple does 5 hits. That is good. Growth speed 60 seconds. Interesting. This is interesting. Man, where were we? Without the photos, I just get confused. Okay. Puff shroom. This is the best one because it does not need any sun. The recharge time is 7 seconds. So you can just equip it if you have some problems. Damage is decent, 20. It's not bad. But it disappears like in 33 seconds. So it disappears automatically. That is the only bad part. Nightcap throws balls of shadow energy that pierce multiple zombies. Mystical attack damage 100 is pretty high. So its attack damage is high. That is good. Fairy ring mushroom. It takes 9 sun. That is a lot of sun. Man, I will never use it, I guess. I will never use it, man. Damages all zombies in 3x3 area around her. Makes free puff shrooms. Oh, wait. It makes free puff shrooms when she defeats zombies. Okay, that is great. So, yeah, of course, you can use that. It is great. It gives you free puff shrooms. And this is an awesome one. Melon pulled. Attack damage is 120, so it's higher than most plants. The only bad thing is it takes 3.5 seconds to load. That is the only bad thing. Otherwise, it's great. And it attacks in a 3x3 area, so that is great. If a lot of zombies are going to attack you, you can use it. You can use it near the lawnmowers and near the zombies area, you can use a snapdragon. So that is the best arrangement I have in my mind. And this one, sawgrass. Damage is 500, which is great. Recharge duration 25 seconds, so okay, it will take a lot of time to recharge, so that is why I might not use it. Otherwise, the attack damage is high. This is aloe vera. It steadily heals all its surrounding plants. So, you know, we can combine this with puff shroom. We can combine this with puff shroom and they will be everlasting because otherwise they die in like 33 seconds. So if we combine them with aloe vera, they will never die. So that will be great. Chomper I never use because it takes 30 seconds to reload. It's good for one time use, but it takes a lot of time to reload, so I don't use it. Snow pea. Yeah, that is nice because it slows down zombies. Otherwise the damage is low, but it slows zombie down, so that is the best part. Pushy willow. That I have not seen before. Pushes back all zombies in her lane when a zombie reaches her. Okay, I guess that is nice. 3 tiles. Shard guard. We have already seen this in Plant vs. Zombie 2. So this is a better defense plan because it just throws back the zombie. about 3 times, then it leaves fall apart and well, it just gets eaten up. Otherwise it is great. Great as a defense plant. And we have Gloom Shroom. Yeah, this is nice. It damages all zombies around it. Attack damage 20, which is decent, not much. Attack speed is good. Damage is decent, not bad. Rapidly fires puffs of gas at zombies. What does stack ability do? Gas puffs can pass through additional zombies. Okay. And the last one is it takes tension. Kale Storm. Rapidly lobs hailstones that damages and slows the first 3 zombies in its lane. So this is good, but Melon Pult might be even better because it does 120 damage. Kale Storm does 24 damage. Okay, this has chill effect. Okay, it has chill effect. Otherwise, Melon Pult is better. It does 120 damage. Okay, and like seriously, the best two plants, the best one plant basically I have is this Snapdragon. Man, this is my personal favorite because it can attack multiple zombies, and if you feed it a taco, it can also attack air zombies. So it's pretty much the only plant I need, except that unless I have a taco, then I would need air attacking plants. But once I have taco, then this is the only thing I need. This is the best one. So this attacks here until I get a taco for my Snapdragon. So yeah, those are the two best plants I have. You can use a star one to attack enemies that go behind you. Okay, I haven't found those enemies yet. So maybe they will come in later stages. So yeah, basically this is all the new plants we have in there. So I hope you can play it on your mobile. I already gave the download link in my previous videos. So maybe it's coming to new countries, so because the description said it is only available in Philippines, but I downloaded it from tab.io app, which I already gave you the link to. So I hope it works for your mobile right now. Otherwise it should be available soon because it's already a very popular game. So yeah, see you later. This is all for today. Bye bye.